Looking backwards, it's quite impressive the results we have obtained in the last 24 months. Let us remember that Linxon only started operations in September 2018. It is a unique company in the market, delivering the technology of an O&M and the project delivery competence of a contractor. But it is not only about delivering substations. Linxon is also there to create long-term value for the society, bringing renewables into the grid, as well as moving people in cities or between cities for our transportation business. Myself and my colleagues spend quite a lot of time with our customers, listening to them to understand their needs, to make sure we are capable to deliver their expectations. We also spend a good amount of time with our employees, not only to onboard them within the project, but to make sure they feel comfortable about what they are doing for Linxon on the long run. Finally, we spend a good amount of time with our shareholders, aligning strategies, delivering not only the quarterly results, but also the long-term projects, which is one of their expectations. To deliver consistently in healthy and safe conditions all our projects, at the same time as finding solutions for the project issues that have happened, sometimes with our customers, sometimes with our suppliers. Collaboration is a word that I would like to highlight because it clearly defines the way that we have been working over the last weeks and months between employees, customers, suppliers, at site, in the office. This is really something we can really be proud of. Innovation is another word that I would like to put on the table. Innovation, when we look at what we did over the last weeks, doing site surveys, doing engineering reviews fully digital, doing drone site tours that we would never have done a year ago. Finally, I would also like to stress some of our commercial successes, getting two fantastic orders in offshore wind, getting two transportation projects in our books, as well as several transmission utilities deciding to award us their transmission substation for their network. This has happened in Scandinavia as well as Iraq. I'm very proud of the achievements of the last weeks and months. First and not the least, we'll need to continue living with the COVID. We know that this is not something that will disappear tomorrow, unfortunately, but we'll find ways to deal with it as we continue collaborating all together. Because of those changes, the role of the office is also meant to change. The office is unlikely to remain the place to work, but the place to collaborate. And because of that new collaboration, we'll need to find ways to deal with colleagues, customers, suppliers, not meeting them as frequently as we were doing before, and having the virtual meeting socialization taking place. Finally, with the change from ABB to Hitachi ABB Power Grids, we'll continue leveraging our shareholders, bringing the technology that is something that differentiates us for our customers. We'll continue doing all those challenges as we did over the last weeks. The conclusion for me is in one sentence: together, creating a better future. Together with our customers, and I really would like to thank them for their so useful collaboration. Together with our employees, because of their resilience and the efforts they have put in everything they did over the last weeks. Together with our suppliers, because without them, we'll not be delivering the projects. And together with our shareholders, because they are allowing us to continue to operate safely in healthy conditions and being a sustainable company. I'm very proud of the achievements of the team over the last weeks. I'm very proud of what we are doing, and I wish we continue and celebrate again in a year to come.